Hello. Is Mohammed the Comforter? This is the fourth video in a series. In this video, let's carefully examine John 16:7-14. What does John 16:7-14 say? Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away. For if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto you. Who is Jesus talking to? Who is the you that Jesus keeps speaking to? You, the disciples. I tell you, the disciples. For you, the disciples. It is expedient for you, the disciples. The Comforter is, first of all, promised to the disciples. So Jesus promised the Comforter. To who? The disciples. When? During their lives. It simply makes no sense to believe that Jesus would make a promise and then not fulfill it during their life when he made the promise to them. And when did Mohammed come? 600 years later. Could Mohammed be the Comforter? Absolutely not. And that ends the debate. Period. End of discussion. There is no possibility Mohammed is the Comforter. Could it be that easy? Yes, it is just that easy. Jesus promised the Comforter to his disciples. Think about what Jesus said. Who was Jesus talking to? The disciples. The Comforter was promised to the disciples. Could Mohammed be the Comforter? There is not a chance in heaven or hell. Mohammed cannot be the Comforter. If you call yourself Muslim, if you want to say, I submit to God, then do not claim the word Comforter and reject the description that Jesus gave. Honor Jesus' words. You say with your mouth, he is a prophet. Well, your words are empty. You don't believe Jesus was a prophet because you don't believe a thing he said. Jesus said, I will send him unto you. I will send him. I will send him unto you. If you call yourself Muslim, read these words. I, Jesus, will send him unto you. Look at that again. I will send him unto you. I will send him. I will send him. If you call yourself Muslim, think about this. Well, who did Muhammad say sent him? Allah. Muhammad did not say Jesus sent me. But Jesus said, I, Jesus, I will send him unto you. I will send the Comforter. It's foolishness, utter, intellectually bankrupt foolishness for you to sit and say, well, Muhammad is the Comforter. He's not. Jesus, who even introduces the concept of the Comforter into your thinking, Jesus said, I will send the Comforter unto you, my disciples. So what now? What do you do with that? If you call yourself Muslim, do not claim the word Comforter, then reject the message of the one Jesus would send. If you honor Jesus as a prophet, honor his words. Mohammed simply does not fit the description which Jesus gave in verse 7. So if you call yourself Muslim, do not claim the word comforter, then reject the description of the one Jesus would send. Jesus said, I will send. Could Muhammad be the comforter? Absolutely not. I sense a common theme here. Muhammad simply does not fit the description which Jesus gave. Muhammad was not sent to the disciples who the Comforter was promised to. So could Muhammad be the Comforter? No, he could not. If you call yourself Muslim, think about it. You owe it to yourself to think honestly about what Jesus said. Who was Jesus talking to? The disciples. The Comforter was promised to the disciples. It's really simple. Muhammad simply does not fit the description which Jesus gave. This means Muhammad cannot possibly be the Comforter. So John 16, verse 7 through 14, cannot be a reference to Muhammad. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.